Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed us. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed us with many blessings, uncountable blessings. And the biggest blessing that Allah Azza wa Jalla has granted us is the blessing of being Muslim, ni'matul Islam. It wasn't in our power to choose which religion we would follow. But Allah Azza wa Jalla chose for us the straight path, which is Islam. And us, we need to be thankful for it. To show gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal, the Almighty. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Allah Azza wa Jal describes in this verse and says that if you show gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal for the blessings that Allah Azza wa Jal has given you, Allah Azza wa Jal will increase for you what your wealth, your ni'mah, your blessings that you have. And if you disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, deny Allah Azza wa Jal, deny the blessings that Allah Azza wa Jal has given you, Allah Azza wa Jal will return that. Instead of having that wealth, Allah Azza wa Jal will revoke it, take it away from you, and will punish you. Dear the brothers and sisters, let's ask ourselves this question. This morning, when we all woke up, how many of us stood in front of a mirror and asked himself, look at me. Look how Allah Azza wa Jal has created me. Look what Allah Azza wa Jal has given me. Look, Allah Azza wa Jal gave me the ability to see, gave me the ability to taste, the ability to hear, the ability to smell, the ability to touch, the ability. All those abilities. How many of us this morning thought about those abilities and said, oh Allah, thank you for that blessing. Oh Allah, thank you for that big ni'mah that you have granted me. Few, or maybe none, because it's a human nature. We humans, we do not realize what we have until we lose it. That's a human nature. It is very hard for us to notice what we have until we lose it. You, the one who has eyes right now, and the one who is blind, which one knows the value of eyes? The one who is blind. You, the one who's walking right now with his full functional legs, and the one who doesn't have any legs and can't walk, who knows the value of his legs? The legs. The one who can't walk and have no legs. That is human nature. But us, what is our duty? Our duty is to recognize what Allah Azza wa Jal has given us, to look back at the ni'mah that Allah Azza wa Jal has granted us, because not everyone has what you have. Look back at your house right now. Think about it. Think about what Allah Azza wa Jal has given you. And ask back yourself. Ask yourself. Did you get this by your own power? If the answer is no, and the answer is that it was a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal, then you need to thank Allah Azza wa Jal for every small ni'mah that Allah Azza wa Jal has given you. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah An-Nahl, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah Azza wa Jal took an example of a township or a village which was Mecca. A township which was Mecca. Allah Azza wa Jal has given them everything, wealth, peace. That is the main two things that people look after in this life. Peace, to live in peace, knowing that no one is going to harm you, no one is going to harm your family, no one is going to harm your children, and wealth. Knowing that you have what you need to eat for your day. You're not stressing about getting what you're going to eat tomorrow. You have everything. فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ. They disobeyed the blessings from Allah Azza wa Jalla, the blessings that Allah Azza wa Jalla has given them. They disobeyed it. They didn't show gratitude towards Allah Azza wa Jalla for the ni'mas that Allah Azza wa Jalla has given them. What was the reward? فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla has given them, Allah Azza wa Jalla has tested them with extreme hunger, poorness, and extreme hunger and unsafety, being scared every time. بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ, which they used to do. So, ikhwati, you need to know for sure that Allah Azza wa Jalla, if you do not be thankful for the things that Allah Azza wa Jalla has given you, Allah Azza wa Jalla will take it away from you. The Prophet, peace be upon him, a hadith that was narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha in Sahih al-Bukhari. She said, the Prophet, peace be upon him, used to pray the whole night until his feet cracks. And Aisha radiallahu anha said to him, O Prophet of Allah, why would you do this when Allah Azza wa Jalla has already forgiven for you your previous sins and your future sins? When Allah Azza wa Jalla has already forgiven for you all these sins, why should you do this? Do you know what the Prophet, peace be upon him, answered? أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا Shouldn't I become a thankful servant? That is how you should show gratitude towards Allah Azza wa Jal. And by showing gratitude towards Allah Azza wa Jal, it is being satisfied for what you have. By being satisfied for what you have, in another way is, Allah Azza wa Jal, when He gives you something, you need to be satisfied for what you have instead of looking what people have. There is a poetry in Arabic that says, إِذَا مَا كُنْتَ ذَا قَلْبٍ قَنُوعٍ فَأَنْتَ وَمَالِكُ الدُّنْيَا سَوَاءٌ, which means, if you have a satisfied heart, satisfied for what you have, not looking at people, what people have, فَأَنْتَ وَمَالِكُ الدُّنْيَا سَوَاءٌ, you and the one who owns the whole world are the same. Because you do not look what people have, you look at what you have, and you are satisfied with it. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, a hadith that was narrated from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said, انظروا إلى من أسفل منكم ولا تنظروا إلى من فوقكم فإنه أجدر ألا تعرفوا نعمة الله عليكم. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, don't you look at those people who are above you, but look at those people who are below you. You yourself, if you have something right now and you are aiming to get more, always think of those people who doesn't even have what you have. Think about those people who doesn't even have children. When you are aiming for more, think about those people who doesn't even have a children. When you are thinking about money, think of those people who doesn't even have a penny. Let's be thankful, akhi. Ikhwati fillah, the ni'mas that we have, we are blinded. Seriously, this is serious talk. We are blinded. We always look for something that is not going to make us satisfied at all. A human being will never be satisfied until he gets into the grave. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, لا يملأ فابن آدم إلا تراب. There is nothing that's going to fill a mouth of a human being unless the sand. It is when he gets into the grave. So, dear brothers and sisters, let's be thankful. Let's show gratitude towards Allah Azza wa Jal and be thankful for what we have. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ, and little are those who are thankful towards Allah Azza wa Jal. Towards Allah Azza wa Jal. إخوتي في الله, هذا وصلوا وسلم على من أمركم الله بالصلاة والسلام عليه حيث قال, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليماً.